Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Jesse Colson Outdoors. My name is Jesse Colson. Heading out ice fishing. I'm gonna go actually camp on the lake for a couple days. So we've got everything loaded up, the trailer, the back of the truck, we're pretty full, so. Snow machine's all on the trailer. Bed of the truck's full. It's snowing. It's like March 10th and it's still snowing. It's weird. Girls are in the back. Dakota's in the back. Karen's in the middle. Papa's driving. We're taking Papa's truck.
I'm so sweaty. Close to Vegas right here.
So, we're heading down the highway. Well, made it to the lake. Got everything loaded up. Let the sleds warm up real quick. We're gonna head out across the ice. So Trenton will be pulling one sled behind him. Dad's got his trailer and his hut. And I've got our floor, three huts, and the other trailer behind me. So plenty of stuff. It's quite a bit of ice, so kind of hard to get moving, but we're gonna load up, see if we can get going, get down on the ice, try to go find somewhere we want to get to. I think the weatherman was right for once. It is snowing like crazy. We just got it to a spot where we want to try to go to. We're gonna try to get huts set up real quick so the girls can get inside. And then we'll worry about trying to get stuff out for fishing, but man, there's 12 inches of snow on the ice. We talked about bringing my side-by-side, and I'm dang glad we didn't. That'd have been a wreck. You probably wouldn't have made it out here. Well, we got everything pretty much set up. We still got my other hut to put up, but I'm not gonna put it up right now, because I don't feel like it. But we got our sleeping quarters put up. Trenton and Dad's sleeping quarters put up. Just working on getting everything moved inside now. So, got, here's Dad's Monster Lodge. Here's the resort. As always, because we rock the resort. Love these things.
Yeah, me too.
There's Bailey and Tosh in there inside. Dad's over there getting some pictures. But got everything put up. Bailey and Tosh are inside right now. I've got another video that goes in depth of how we put these up, so I didn't record setting the huts up or anything like that. So I'll link it in probably one of these top corners. We'll get the video linked. And then you guys check that out if you're interested in setting them up. The one's been up for a couple years now, I think. Has been up since last year. So I'll link it again up here if anybody's interested in seeing how they set up. We've got the floors in both of them. I haven't built the floor for my other one. I've been lazy and busy and just haven't had the time. At some point we'll get the floor built for the other one. When I do that, I'll bring you guys with us to do it. But for now, pretty much got everything set up that we need. I'll try to do a little video about this trailer. I know I've had a couple people ask about it, and I keep meaning to do a video. I've just, again, been too busy. Running a business and volunteer firefighter and full-time job. So, super busy. Haven't had a whole lot of time to dedicate to trying to get some of the stuff people have asked about recorded, so I do apologize, but I'll get a quick little video of how we built this trailer at some point this weekend or something. It's just kind of a camping trip in a way. I'm not holding a whole lot of confidence that we're going to catch fish, because if everybody's been watching the videos this winter, you've seen our fish catch has been pretty sad. That's been kind of everywhere around. Every lake around here has been pretty sad this year. So anyway, getting it all put together, got a little bit more stuff to unload out of the small trailer, so I'm gonna get that stuff unloaded, waiting for Dad and Trenton to finish in their hut so I can put Trenton's bed in there. He's gonna kick it with Papa for the weekend, so as soon as they get done doing what they're doing in his hut, we'll take the rest of the stuff out and get Coda's bed set up, get all that stuff set up and taken care of, and then I think it's gonna be pretty close to lunchtime. So
here you go, Trenton.
Hey, come over to visit Trenton and Papa for a minute. We're getting all sat up. Wind is ridiculous. I think it's going to be another trip like the trip Trenton and I had a couple years ago. That was 3 days of nonstop 50 mile an hour wind down here, about a mile down the lake. It was stinking ridiculous. I hope we don't have that trip. I hope it gets nice later or tomorrow, because that trip, I didn't sleep a whole lot. I laid awake holding on to the side of the ice hut because I was concerned the ice hut was going to fly away.
Yeah, that was when we learned how crazy the straps on this ice hut are. Not yeah. Even one of them came undone.
Learned how impressive that resort hut is. All right, well, back over here and mine and the ladies' huts. So they're right there getting their covers all straightened out. Get their bags all situated under their beds. All the pole bags and stuff are just gonna stick under their beds for now. Heater, battery box, it's all on that end. There's Coco. She's kicking it down here, staying nice and cozy.
On my side of the bed.
I think I gotta make a little room right there for the cooler.
Dad, I'm
showing, okay? Yeah, you're being silly, huh?
I like to jump up and down on the cooler.
Yeah, don't do that, please. You break the lid of the cooler.
Hi. Now you can get back to you.
These are my roommates for the night. For the next 2 nights. So, funny enough, it's raining outside right now. The wind is blowing about 900 miles an hour. And it's raining. Makes no sense. Stinking crazy. It's supposed to snow. So, could turn interesting if it starts to... Hopefully it doesn't just keep raining, because that would not be good. It's really getting after it. It's raining hard. I'm hoping it quits and it doesn't get super, super cold after it rains, because this snow is settling hard. It's settling fast with all the rain. I've never been ice fishing in the rain, so I guess this is a first for us. But we got everything situated in the hut, working on just tying up the loose ends, get pillows, things like that out. About to set up the computer and get it ready for the ladies to maybe watch a movie. And then after we do all that, I'm gonna get a pole in the water. Haven't even done that yet. But anyway, imagine you can hear that. That's the rain. Hopefully you can hear it anyway. Stinking crazy. I imagine the temperature will drop here pretty soon. It'll probably turn into snow, but. So, the girls and I are just hanging out. Trenton and Papa are over in Papa's hut, and he has his camera over there with them. So his video is actually going to be completely separate from this one. So if you guys want to check out his video, go to TJC Outdoors 16. It's his channel. I'll link it either up in the top or down in the comments. But check his channel out if you haven't subscribed to his channel yet. Subscribe to it. He hasn't been putting a whole lot on, but we haven't been able to go do a whole lot. So definitely check his channel out. Hopefully pretty soon we're going to start getting to do some more stuff. It's the 10th of May today, I think. Yep, 10th of May. Or 10th of March. May. Jeez. Year's already going fast enough. 10th of March. Today. So. Sounds like it starts snow again. But. 10th of March. So hopefully. Mid-April. We should be getting out on the boat. I'm hoping. But. We're still getting pounded with snow here in Wyoming. We've been. Getting hit pretty hard. Last couple storms we've had have been pretty massive. The video I put up, probably the last video, plowing the snow in the Ranger. That was out of Dad's place. Snow was that deep all over the place out there. Big drifts, and it's pretty awesome. So we've had that storm, and then we had a couple of other decent snowstorms since that. They've dropped down another 6 inches or better of snow. And then with the storm that's coming in right now, hey, put your pole back over the hole. There you go. The one that's coming in right now is supposed to drop up to another 8 inches, it sounds like. So could be getting pretty interesting. We might end up with a whole bunch of snow, but.
Ooh.
Oh yeah, we got one. All right, we're on a fish. Come here, Tosh. Come here. Get over here, start reeling. Take your gloves off.
Start reeling.
Reel, Tosh.
Reel.
Go slow, don't go hard.
Or you'll let the fish go. Tosh, I got a fish!
Tasha, pay attention.
Tosh's on a fish in here.
Pay attention.
Go slow. Outside of the door.
Slow. Slow.
Whoa, that's a big, holy crap.
You need me to come in there?
Hold on.
What is that?
It's a ling.
That's a big old ling. Good job, Tom. don't squeal like that, please.
Look at that monster. He is huge.
Here, let me see that.
Awesome.
Tasha.
Forever and ever.
All right. Tasha just caught this nice big huge ling.
The guy's been running around messing with us.
Nice fish. Really nice. Probably 24, 30 inches. Somewhere in there.
Fish. All right, I'm
going to
go back to my tent.
Good job,
Tosh.
There you go, Tosh. Take your gloves off, please.
Yeah, it'll ruin your gloves.
I don't
want to
get sun on my hands.
Here.
Ew.
There's Tosh holding her fish. Good job, kiddo.
Can I? I want to pet it.
That's a nice big old ling. We're going to get this hook out real quick. First fish of the trip.
First fish so forever.
We're going to show mom this when we get him.
The best time.
All right. Grab my phone.
Okay.
But let me get this one rebaited. And back down real quick. And then go back to what I was trying to do. We've had fish messing around with us all night, so.
Oh, can I tell them something, Daddy?
Yeah, go ahead. Just
can
back
I
up a little. Back up a little.
Mm-hmm. Guys, guess what? That was the best time of my life. I caught the biggest bling I could ever catch.
Bailey set the camera down.
That was awesome. It was so big. I caught it like this. It was this big.
Bailey's got one over here messing around.
Yeah. I got another one away.
Come here, Bailey.
I'm coming over there.
Come here. Start reeling. Real slow.
Oh Billy, this is yours because I already got mine and this is your turn.
Keep reeling, just real slow. Just like we did with Tasha. Once we get it up to the top of the hole, I'm going to grab a hold of it, okay?
Okay. Another ling! Another ling, Trenton!
Get it?
I got the... Bailey got the second one because it was all the way on my pool.
Yep. Yeah. There's another nice one.
Looky there.
There's one for Bailey.
Oh, one for you.
I literally just put that back down.
Nice. He's running a ball jig, too.
That's my fish.
There's another nice one. Come here, Bailey. Let me...
Sweet sugar pie.
All right, well. Guess what? I can't say we got skunk this time.
Well,
wait.
Bailey and Tasha didn't get skunked.
Yeah. All right.
These darn fish are so
good. Good job.
Come here, Bailey. Grab that camera real quick, Trent. Come here, Bailey. Put your hands on it.
I'm happy for you, Bailey.
All right.
Towards the camera. Look towards the camera, baby. There's Bailey's fish.
Oh,
it moved. Touch it. All right, I'm gonna go back outside and get baited back up. Well, that was cool. Two fish within 30 seconds or minute or whatever it was.
One second.
I don't even know how long it was, but that was pretty cool.
That it was in 1 minute.
Well, we're gonna light this back up, get it back down. Then I guess I gotta go outside and clean some fish. Another fish right there. See if we get the next. This next one's mine.
Pull! Dad, you just got a pull. You'll get to roll it in. Reel it in?
No, it's not on there.
No, there's a pull. Must have got away, though.
You got all right, let's throw this one back down. We'll see if we can get another one
for
that
my
quick.
Dad! Let's get another one for my dad.
All right, here we go. Back to the bottom.
Dad, can I see, tell the GoPro something?
Yes, you can.
Okay, can I throw this in?
Yeah, go ahead.
So this is funny. That was really quick. It was like in 1 minute we caught that fish. Like, I caught that fish in 1 minute.
Now you gotta get a picture of you holding it.
Yeah, we gotta get a picture of me holding it. We really couldn't, though.
Well, we're going to.
Yeah, we're going to. But we just couldn't that time. Because it was ginormous. It was like this size. I thought it was going to be like big. It was massive.
Got it set. Baby's pretty excited. All right. Resat. The floor's gooey. Oh, yeah. Gotta love it. Ling fishing at its best. All right. Well, we are cooking up some dinner. Got some antelope brats going right now. Getting the kids' cooked up. They're not spicy. We got some spicy ones down there for me. These are some antelope brats from the antelope we harvested this spring or this fall. I believe some of these are from Trenton's. So he turned 12 this year, got the chance to hunt. Got himself a couple antelope tags. And, oh, got a fish over there. I'm just seeing the fish on Vexler out of the side of my eye. But anyway, so he got himself a couple antelope tags, so he helped provide meat for our winter. And so we're cooking those up right now. Got some Serrano ones, some Serrano pepper ones that we made that I'll cook after I get theirs cooked. But pretty awesome. Couldn't be more proud of my kids. They're helping provide the fish. So awesome. Helping provide antelope and deer and everything. So super, super proud of them. So awesome that they're willing to come out and hang out and do this with me. But nope, we're going to cook. Haven't had any more bites yet. They keep swimming around, so maybe here in a little bit I'm going to have to pull them up, light them up, make sure we still got bait on them. All of that. Tosh, get your hand out of your mouth, sweetie. And then put them back down so maybe we'll catch a couple more before the end of the night. Well, no more fishies yet. But haven't really been trying extremely hard either. So, got our poles all put away. Girls are watching a movie. I think we're watching Santa Claus Comes to Town. Yep. On the computer. Got the computer set up so that they can watch TV for a couple minutes.
Hey.
Or watch
this
a movie.
Is called Santa Claus Coming to Town.
Yep. Here's the girl's bed. Dakota's already crashed. It never takes her long. Especially when we're on the ice. She lays down and she just curls up and she's done. So, but had dinner. Dinner was yummy. And we're just relaxing and getting ready to go to bed. So, anyway, I think I'm probably going to do each day as a single video, so this will be day one. I'll be here tomorrow and part of Sunday, so maybe three videos out of it. But it was quite the day. Snowed, rained, never had rain when I'm camped on the ice, so that was kind of a first. It's pretty interesting, and it reminded me I'm gonna seam seal this. I'm gonna get the, excuse me. I'm gonna get the seam seal goo. I'm gonna seam seal all the seams all the way around. And then we're gonna get that waterproof tent spray. We're gonna spray the whole entire outside of the hut. I intended on doing that last year, because even when you get some snow on it, it'll start to leak a little bit. But kind of forgot, so good reminder that I need to definitely seam seal it. So we'll get it all seam sealed, and then we'll get the waterproof spray put on it. That should help some. But I get home and definitely gonna have to set this thing up inside the shop and get it nice and hot, get it dried out, because it's still wet. It did dry out some. I was actually pretty impressed how much it did actually dry out, but need to make sure we set it up when we get home and dry it the rest of the way. But anyway, I think we're gonna call it the end of the video and get in bed and finish this movie for a little bit. As soon as this one's over, we're gonna
turn it off and go to sleep. So we will see you guys in the morning.
Bye.
Oh, girls want to say bye. Say good night. Talk to you tomorrow.